so watch for them. Make sure that everyone hides his week's supply of food. Burying it in the vegetable garden is probably the safest place until the enemy has passed. A service rifle will kill anything from a Nazi to an elephant. And provided the Home Guard get blood on every bullet, or even every second bullet, things will be very unpleasant for the Nazis. The experienced and practiced shot should have no difficulty in bagging 5 Nazis in a charge as short as 50 yards. Pick out your enemy and shoot him. Dozens of tricks, all very demoralizing for the enemy, can be devised with just a little hard thinking. The average Britisher's brain works quicker than the average German's, which is a telling factor.
In the skies over southern England, the Royal Air Force holds firm. The Battle of Britain.
The gratitude of every home in our island and in our empire goes out to the British airmen who, undaunted by odds, are turning the tide of the World War by their prowess and by their devotion. Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few.
Hitler has lost the Battle of Britain by day. He now sends his bombers to attack Britain's cities and the British people by night. Gladys Cox and her husband Ralph live in Lymington Mansions, North London.
3 alerts so far. Most of the night spent in the cellar. Anti-aircraft guns booming all night. There was the glow in the sky of a fire, and to the south and southeast, shrapnel bursting like winking stars in the clear atmosphere. After the first all clear this morning, I hurried out to do the weekend shopping. I greeted Mr. Palmer at the fishmonger's with, "Well, we're still alive." And kicking, he added, smiling broadly.
"Here is the news, and this is Alvar Liddell reading it. Today was the most costly for the German Air Force for nearly a month."
Ralph ran into Mr. Breville Smith, who hailed him in friendly fashion. People we have known for years by sight and have passed without recognition have suddenly become very friendly. It seems to require a war to break down English reserve.
"That certain night, the night we met, there was magic abroad in the air. There were angels dining at the Ritz, and a nightingale sang in Berkeley."
The next raid brings disaster for Gladys and Ralph Cox.
The bottom of our world has dropped out. I'm so dazed, so tired, so numb. I can hardly think, much less write. Ralph and I went along to the flat, my neat and orderly home, a scene of indescribable desolation. Our marriage certificate, insurance policy, all my letters, not even the ashes remained. Under my bed, my trinket box was lying open, its contents scattered over the wet carpet. Everything of the least value removed. All the work of looters.
facing the full horror of the Blitz, the men of the Heavy Rescue Service. East End bricklayer Bill Regan.
Not much sleep tonight. At daylight, we found our job in Dunkeld Street, off Abbots Road. There was quite a mess. Little hope of finding survivors. We gathered 3 bushel baskets of remains. I picked up 2 left feet. One of the men saw a body perched on the rooftop. Nobby Clark climbed up and recovered it. It was badly mutilated. It was some time before we were even able to identify it as female. Some of the men were feeling queasy, so rum was dished out. I was TT, so I gave mine away.